Hi, welcome back to Temple of Life. We are doing a video where we are making a potion. We're going to mix some cinnamon into this potion bottle here, potion bowl. That's a good amount of cinnamon right there. And we're just going to take a tiny little pinch of clove. That should be good right there. And then after the tea is starting to brew, we're going to add some of the bean here, this vanilla bean. We're gonna get a little scoop of that out of there real quick onto the spoon. Just gonna, scrape that on there. We're gonna need to cut it open a little more. So, we do this. And we make sure that we lean it on some of this right here. We put it on tissue paper. That's for the first serving. So, yes. As soon as the water is boiled and everything. And then we'll get that handled with that first serving. Because this itself is going to be part of the serving. And then this will be my serving right here on the knife. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the rest of this, we're gonna store it in here. Nice and careful, nice and gentle. Because even vanilla beans, they have emotions, they have feelings, even after they've already been harvested.
So you put in ground cinnamon.
Yep, I put about a tablespoon worth of ground cinnamon for two
ground
servings.
Ground clove.
And about a pinch of ground clove.
Of vanilla bean.
And what it's supposed to do is it's supposed to relax you. And the vanilla bean is supposed to give you energy. So the two of them together are energy and relaxation. It's a kind of good energy that doesn't make you feel like you're going to just like... in 5 seconds, you know what I mean? It's just like, ugh.
Okay, so we're waiting for the tea to make.
Yep. Need at least 2 bags in there, but the 1 bag should make at least 4 bags, which is 4 cups, right?
So what? Can you do that? You got 2 hands at the moment.
Yep, I do have two hands. 2 bags. Wow.
Nice tattoo.
Well, thank you.
So tell them what the tattoo means.
This tattoo is a symbolization of Jesus Christ's birth. It is the star that marked the day of his birth.
You want to show that one or no?
Yeah, sure.
And what do this mean?
That one right there, it is the symbol of our coven.
Cool. Nice.
Is it still burnt?
Huh?
Is it still burnt?
What do you mean burnt?
Like, is there still sunburn on it?
Huh?
Is there still sunburn on my back?
No, there's not, no. Yeah.
So cool. I just wonder why it hurts when people touch my tattoo.
I don't know. Yeah, we do need to get our tattoo fit in. Well, you still sit nicely, I guess because you're white. It looked nicely though, you know. It still needs a little color in.
I think it has to do with this quality of the ink.
That probably, yeah, because Christine don't know what she was doing with a, you know, black person. Because she had to do my tattoo like 4 times, she had to retrace it 2 more times.
Yeah.
That shit hurt like hell.
Okay, so what we're going to do here is, I'm going to need to get a spoon to scrape some of this. Is there somebody outside of the room?
I think kids. You know, there's a lot of kids over here.
These spoons are perfect for the purpose of what we have to do. See, what we're gonna do is we're gonna gently scrape this at the bottom here.
Huh. Ta-ta. I need another fan in here, maybe.
Put a little bit on your spoon. And a little bit on my spoon. And then when the tea is done being made, we add those ingredients, plus a little bit of sugar.
Cool.
And then our recipe will be complete, and our spell will be complete. positive energy all around.
Hello.
I love it, right? It's just so much fun.
Do you feel the energy rising?
I feel like too much energy. And we have firepower. And then tea, this specific tea. Ooh, I love the way that heat feels. Ooh, girl, yes. Okay. I love fire. I love fire. Fire is amazing. See, we have to put it all the way in the center here.
How often?
Tea is actually really good for energy-wise, mm-hmm. and it's got the least amount of caffeine in it, but it still wakes you up in a positive, less aggressive way, because coffee kind of is, you know, it's a laxative.
How often to do this spell?
You can do this as many times as you need to, as long as there is a crescent moon present of any kind. I would recommend you do it during the waxing phase of the moon, because that is when the time is coming that the sun and the moon are kind of like doing their phases. The moon is going through the phases right now of waxing, so this is the best time to do this kind of recipe.
Showing your dress, how cute it is. Especially, you know, the sparkly one. So cute. Nice dress.
This dress is a very witchy style dress. I'm wearing black in honor of Lady Nyx and Lady Kali.
How you doing?
Look how beautiful that tea is turning out. Oh my god, it's gorgeous. Yeah, we're gonna need another spoon for this because we're gonna want
to stir. Our body don't know what to do with drink. Doing energy drinks, doing tea, pop.
We're just like, what the fuck, man? We're just gonna have to get this going a little faster. Because we want this video to last a while, but we also want to talk about a lot of other stuff.
Sure.
And it's gonna be a cup of tea.
Plants.
Yes, plants.
Yeah, because you said it'll take a moment. So, with the plants, we can still do magic well.
Yes. You can even write down your wish on a stone, and you can put it in the soil with the plant. And the plant will take the energy from that wish, and Mother Nature herself will grant your wish.
Or however you can, like, write your wish or desire on the paper and
yes,
put a date.
You can also take one of the leaves if you ask permission from the plant, of course. If you have the ability to be an empath and you ask the plant, hey, is it okay if I take one of your leaves? If it says yes, if the plant says yes, you may take one of my leaves, then you take one of their leaves, but you do it gently. You don't do it to hurt the plant, you do it gently. For, say, example, this one's telling me no, I can't take it.
Once you take a leaf, then what you do with it?
You can write a symbol on the leaf and then put it right back in the soil, giving it back to the plant as nutrients. My darling, may I use a plant leaf from yours? Thank you very much. I'm going to take this little one right here, okay? And you just gently snip it off. And then you take the leaf. This is the one I was given permission to use.
Yeah.
And then what I'm going to do for her, because she let me use her leaf, I'm going to take some vanilla bean, which has some natural nutrients added to it. And I'm going to offer it to the plant.
Okay, you got 50 seconds.
50 seconds? Okay.
I don't know. Yeah.
And then there we go. And we add the leaf right back into the soil, right where it needs to be. And that is plant magic. Thank you for visiting this channel. I hope you like, subscribe, and comment on this channel.